Hello everyone, and welcome back to Math220A, Mathematical Logic. Lecture 24, Definability in Saturated Models. We know that prime models elementarily embed into all models of a given theory T. Turns out that saturated models embed all small models. Let's make this precise with the following definition. We say that M, a model of a theory T, is kappa universal for an infinite cardinal kappa if for all N model of T such that the cardinality of N is strictly less than kappa, there exists an elementary embedding F of N into M. And we say that M is universal if it is the cardinality of M plus universal. Lemma: let kappa be an infinite cardinal if M is kappa saturated, then M is kappa plus universal. Proof. So let M be a kappa-saturated model given, and let N be a model of T with cardinality of M less or equal than kappa. Then we can enumerate the base set. So let N alpha, for alpha an ordinal less than kappa, enumerate the base set N of the structure N, and we let the set A alpha be the set of all elements N beta for beta less than alpha. We build a sequence of partial elementary maps F0 extended by F1, extended by F2, etc., extended by F alpha, etc., for all ordinals alpha less than kappa, such that F alpha is a partial elementary map from the set A alpha to M. So we let F0 be the empty map if alpha is a limit ordinal. We will take F alpha to be the union of F beta for beta less than alpha, which by the inductive assumption will be partial elementary as a union of an increasing chain of partial elementary maps. And given F alpha, a partial elementary map from M alpha to M, we consider the set of formulas in a single free variable, gamma of V, which we take to consist of all formulas of the form phi of V F alpha A bar, such that N satisfies phi of N alpha A bar, and A bar belongs to the set A alpha less than omega. So A bar is a finite tuple from the set A alpha. Now, as the map F alpha is partial elementary, the set of formulas gamma of V is consistent with the theory of M. So to see this, first let us note that gamma of V, the set of formulas, is closed under conjunctions by the definition. Since if two formulas hold on an alpha, then the conjunction also holds on an alpha. Hence, in order to show that every finite set of formulas from gamma is consistent, it is enough to show that each formula in gamma is consistent. Now, in order to see this, note that if n satisfies phi of an alpha A bar, this means that in particular n satisfies the formula exists V phi of V A bar, and A bar is from is a tuple in the set A alpha, which is in the domain of F alpha. This tells us that exists V phi of V F alpha of A bar is satisfied in M, and hence the formula phi of V F alpha A bar is also satisfiable in M. This tells us that gamma of V is a partial type, and note that the cardinality of the set of parameters used in this partial type, which is just F alpha of A alpha, is strictly less than kappa, because A alpha had size strictly less than kappa by the definition. So gamma of V is realized by some element B in M using that M is kappa saturated. Then we take F alpha plus 1 to be F alpha together with the pair N alpha B. This is the desired partial elementary map whose domain contains A alpha. Now we take F to be the union of this chain of partial elementary maps F alpha for alpha less than kappa. Then by this construction of this chain of elementary maps, F is an elementary embedding of N into M. This concludes the proof of the lemma. Using this, we can now provide the following characterization of kappa-saturated models. Let kappa be an infinite cardinal, then the following conditions are equivalent. 1. M is kappa saturated. 2. M is kappa homogeneous. And kappa plus universal. And if kappa is greater or equal than aleph 1, so it's in fact uncountable, then 1 and 2 are also equivalent to the condition 3, M is kappa homogeneous, and kappa universal, as opposed to kappa plus in item 2. proof. We have proved earlier that if a model is kappa saturated, then it is kappa homogeneous. And in the previous lemma, we have proved that kappa saturated implies kappa plus universal. So this shows that 1 implies 2 by an earlier result, together with the lemma that we have just proved. The implication 2 implies 3 is obvious. Because clearly, kappa plus universality implies kappa universality. So it remains to show that 2 implies 1. And if kappa is uncountable, then 3 also implies 1. Let M be kappa homogeneous and let A be a subset of M with the cardinality of A strictly less than kappa and P a one type over A in M. Then we can find some N, a model of the A theory of M, so with the parameters for the set A all named by new constant symbols, such that A is a subset of N and there exists A, an element in N, realizing P. Simply because every type is realized in some elementary extension of M. Now, if kappa is equal to aleph naught, then we can choose such a model N of countable cardinality and if kappa is greater or equal than aleph 1, then we can choose N with N of cardinality less than kappa, because the set of parameters is countable. So by the downwards Löwenheim's column, we can find a model, an elementary substructure of the elementary extension of N realizing P. So that it contains both A and the realization of the type P little a. So altogether, this is just the cardinality of A, hence, plus the cardinality of the language, which is countable, hence it's less than kappa. Now, by assumption, there exists an elementary embedding F of N into M. Here we're using the universality assumption as F restricted to A is partial elementary by kappa homogeneity of M there exists some B in M such that the type of B over the set of parameters A in M is equal to the type of F of A over the set of parameters F of capital A in M. So we are given the elementary map F restricted to A and we're extending it to one additional element B, which sends B to F of A. And we know that this is equal to the type of A over A in N which is just P. Hence, we have found an element B in M, which realizes the type P. So B is an element in M realizing P. So we conclude that M is kappa saturated. In particular, we have the following corollary: M is saturated if and only if M is homogeneous and universal. And we conclude the discussion here by showing that if M and N are two saturated models of T, of the same cardinality kappa, then M is isomorphic to N. We have already seen this theorem in the special case of countable saturated models, but the same result holds for models of any cardinality kappa. And the proof is similar to it. So we already know this holds for kappa equal to Aleph naught. Hence, without loss of generality, we may assume that kappa is uncountable, greater or equal than Aleph 1. Then we let M alpha for alpha less than kappa enumerate M, and similarly we have N alpha for alpha less than kappa enumerate N, where M and N are saturated models of T of the same cardinality kappa. As usual, we build a sequence of partial elementary maps F0 extended by F1, etc., F alpha for alpha less than kappa, such that the element M alpha will belong to the domain of F alpha plus 1, and the element N alpha will belong to the image of F alpha plus 1. We will let A alpha denote the domain of the map F alpha in this construction. So we will ensure that the cardinality of the domain A alpha is less or equal than the cardinality of alpha, of the ordinal alpha, plus Aleph naught, which is going to be strictly less than kappa for all alpha. This inequality is using that kappa is uncountable, greater or equal than Aleph 1. So in particular, adding Aleph naught won't break the inequality. Towards this purpose, we let F0 be the empty map, and we let F alpha be the union of F beta for beta less than alpha for alpha less than kappa, a limit ordinal. Now let's ensure the successor step. So suppose F alpha is a partial elementary map. By saturation of N, we can find B in N such that n satisfies phi of b f alpha of a bar if and only if m satisfies phi of m alpha a bar, and this holds for all phi L formulas and all a bar finite tuples from the set A alpha. So this is the usual argument we have seen many times, which allows us using that F alpha is partial elementary, we can show the consistency of the corresponding set of formulas, and then by saturation of N we can realize the corresponding type, since the total number of parameters involved in it is going to be F alpha of A alpha, which by the inductive assumption is strictly less than kappa. Then we take G alpha to be F alpha together with the pair M alpha B, which is a partial elementary map. Similarly, by saturation of M, we can find an element A in M, such that this time N satisfies phi of N alpha G of A bar, if and only if M satisfies phi of A bar, and this holds for all phi in L and all tuples A bar in A alpha together with the additional element M alpha. So this is the domain of G alpha. And we're looking at the finite tuples, all possible finite tuples from this set. So this is just as before, but working with the partial elementary map given by the inverse of G alpha. Then we take finally F alpha plus 1 to be G alpha together with A N alpha. This is again a partial elementary map. And if we take F to be the union of all F alpha for alpha less than kappa, then we see that F is an isomorphism. Well, it's a partial elementary map, which is with the domain given by M and the image given by N. So in particular, this is an isomorphism from M to N. So this concludes the proof of the theorem. Next, we consider definability in saturated models. An important point here is that the automorphism group of a saturated model is sufficiently rich so that we can see over which sets of parameters a given definable set can be defined from looking at the automorphism group of the structure over a given set of parameters and see if the set is fixed or not by the corresponding automorphism group. So there's some kind of Galois theoretic connection here. So let's begin with the following proposition. Let M be saturated and let A be a subset of M of cardinality strictly less than the cardinality of the model. Then assume that X is a subset of some power of M, which is definable with parameters from M, but we don't restrict these parameters in any way, so it can use arbitrary tuple of elements from M in its definition by first order formula with parameters. But then we have that X is A definable, so can be defined by a formula which only uses parameters from A, if and only if every automorphism of M that fixes A pointwise fixes the set X setwise. So the elements of X can be permuted, but the set X as a whole is fixed by every such automorphism. We already saw some variant of this when we talked about any two elements of the same type being connected by an automorphism of some elementary extension. So this shows that the advantage of saturated models is because we can do things in the model itself that we usually could only do in an elementary extension. Proof. First, we show the implication from left to right. So assume that A bar is a finite tuple from the set of parameters capital A, and the set X consists of all tuples B bar in Mn, such that M satisfies phi of B bar A bar. So we can think about it as the formula phi of X A bar with parameters and the set capital A, defining the set X. So it's exactly the set of realizations of this formula. And assume that sigma is an arbitrary automorphism of M. Then we can consider the image of the set X under this automorphism. It will consist of all tuples C bar in M to the N, such that M satisfies phi of sigma inverse of C bar, applied coordinate wise, of course, A bar. But now this is equal to the set of all tuples C bar in Mn, such that M satisfies phi of C bar sigma of A bar. So here we're using that sigma is an automorphism. M, hence it preserves arbitrary formulas without parameters. But now this in turn is equal to C bar in Mn, such that M satisfies phi of C bar A bar. Here we're using that sigma of A bar is equal to A bar. So because sigma fixes A, the set capital A, pointwise. But this is, of course, again, just the set X, because X was given by the set of all realizations of the formula phi of X bar A bar. Now let's consider the converse implication from right to left. Let psi be a formula where we consider psi of V bar M bar. Assume that this defines X, where M bar is some tuple of parameters in M of some length K. Then we can consider the partial type gamma of V bar W bar, which consists of the formulas psi of V bar M bar and not psi of W bar M bar together with all formulas of the form phi of V bar equivalent to phi of W bar for phi an LA formula. So you're allowed to use parameters in A. Suppose that gamma together with the A theory of M is satisfiable then by saturation of M and the assumption that A has cardinality strictly less than the cardinality of M, we can find some tuple A bar B bar realizing gamma in M. But then we can let F be the map which is the identity on A, the set of parameters capital A, and such that F of A bar is equal to B bar coordinate wise. And moreover, by the choice of gamma, F is a partial elementary map. So here note we're using that gamma was defined to contain all formulas of the form phi of V bar, if and only if double, phi of W bar, for phi an arbitrary LA formula. So then any realization A bar B bar of gamma would satisfy that A bar and B bar have the same type over the set of parameters capital A. Hence, if we define the map this way, it is a partial elementary map. But now, using that M is in particular homogeneous, because we know that saturated models are also homogeneous, this partial elementary map F extends to an automorphism sigma of M. But we also have that M satisfies psi of A bar M bar and not psi of B bar M bar. Because again, this was these two sentences were contained in gamma and A bar and B bar are realizing gamma by assumption. Thus, we would have that A belongs to X, the tuple A bar belongs to X, and its automorphic image, sigma of A bar, which is B bar, does not belong to X. But this is a contradiction, because we're assuming that the set X is fixed set-wise by any automorphism, sigma, which fixes A point-wise. And here sigma is extending F, which fixes the set capital A point-wise. So this gives us a contradiction. Hence, gamma is not satisfiable, and therefore it follows that there must be some finite subset of gamma which is not satisfiable with the A theory of M. So there exist some LA formulas phi 1 through phi m, so some finitely many LA formulas, such that we have the following condition. So such that M satisfies for all V bar, for all W bar, if we have that phi I of V bar holds if and only if phi I of W bar, so they agree on all these finitely many formulas, then they also have to agree on psi. So we have psi of V bar M bar holds if and only if psi of W bar M bar. Let's call this condition star. So this we get because gamma, we assume that gamma is not consistent with the A theory of M. So this means that in particular, there must be some finitely many formulas from the second part of the definition of gamma. So that being equivalent on all of them implies the first part of gamma cannot be satisfied by V and W. Importantly, all of the phi i's have parameters in A. Okay, so next for tau, an arbitrary map from 1 through n to the set 0, 1, we let theta tau of V bar be the formula given by the conjunction over all I such that tau of I is equal to 1 of phi I of V bar, and for all I such that tau of I is equal to 0, we take the negation of phi I of V bar. And so here I belongs to the set 1 through n in both cases. So for each, basically for each subset of the set 1 through n, we have the corresponding theta tau. Now, if we have theta tau of A bar and theta tau of B bar both hold in M, then by the condition star, so we see that A bar and B bar satisfy exactly the same phi i's from the set of all phi i's. Oh, and here it should be M everywhere, excuse me. So we have I in 1 through M for each of the formulas phi I. So then by star, we have that A bar is in X if and only if B bar is in X. For some, so if two tuples A bar and B bar satisfy exactly the same subset of the phi i's for some subset tau, then they both have to, belonging to the set X happens simultaneously. But now we can take S to consist of those tau maps from 1 through M to the set 0, 1, such that M satisfies theta tau of A bar for some A bar in X. Then we have that A bar is in X if and only if M satisfies the disjunction over all tau in S, theta tau of V bar. Simply because every tuple has to realize some set of theta taus, and we have collected in the set capital S exactly those choices for which some realization is in X, and hence by the previous explanation, any realization of the same theta tau is also in X. And finally, note that this whole formula, the disjunction tau in S theta tau, is an LA formula. because each phi I was an LA formula. Then we defined theta tau to be a Boolean combination of the phi i's. And finally, this is again disjunction of Boolean combinations of phi i's. So it is an LA formula. So we conclude that x is definable with parameters from A as wanted. So this concludes the proof of the theorem. Every structure comes equipped with two important closure operators. Definition one, so assume M an L structure. Then one, we say that an element B in M is definable over a set of parameters A, subset of M, if the set consisting of the single element B is A definable, so can be defined with parameters from A. And two, we say that an element B in M is algebraic over A subset of M if there exists a finite A definable set X such that B is an element of X. So of course, if an element is definable over A, then it is also algebraic over A. And finally, three, we will write DCL M of A to be the set of all elements B in M such that B is definable over A. And similarly, we will write ACL of A to denote the set of all B in M such that B is algebraic over A. We have the following characterizations of these two closures in a saturated model. So let M be saturated, A a subset of M, so that A has cardinality strictly less than the cardinality of M. Then B is definable over A if and only if B is fixed by all automorphisms of M that fix A pointwise. Proof. This follows immediately from the previous proposition. Since by the proposition we have that the set consisting of a single element B, which is of course definable using B as a parameter in M by the formula X equals to B. So we can say then that B is A definable, the set consisting of B, if and only if every automorphism of M fixing A pointwise fixes the set consisting of the single element B. So it's just the application, direct application of the proposition, and it's exactly what our corollary says. The situation is a bit more interesting for the algebraic closure. Proposition Let M be saturated. Let A be a subset of M of cardinality less than the cardinality of M. And B an element of M. Then the following are equivalent. 1. B is algebraic over A. 2. B has only finitely many images under all automorphisms of M which fix A pointwise. And 3, the type of B over A in M has finitely many realizations. Proof. One implies two. Let X be a finite, a definable set such that B is an element of X. By the proposition, any automorphism of M fixing A pointwise permutes the set X because it has to preserve X setwise. Hence, B has to be sent to some other element in X. So there are only finitely many possible images for B under such automorphisms. Next, we show 2 implies 3. If C realizes the type of B over A, then since M is in particular homogeneous, we know that there is an automorphism of M fixing A pointwise and mapping B to C, because they have the same type over A. Thus, if B has only finitely many images under automorphisms fixing A, then the type of B over A has only finitely many realizations. And finally, we show that 3 implies 1. Suppose that P, which we take to be the type of B over A in M, has exactly n realizations. So we assume it has finitely many, so let it denote this by n. And let gamma be a set of formulas in the free variables v0 through vn, so n plus 1 variables in total. We let it consist of the A theory of M together with all formulas phi of vi for phi in P and I ranging from 0 to n. And we also express that all the variables are distinct, so vi is not equal to vj. For 0 less or equal than I less than j less or equal than n. Now, by assumption, P has only n realizations in M, and M is saturated, and the cardinality of A is less than the cardinality of M, it follows that gamma is not satisfiable, because if we could realize gamma, we could find n plus 1 realizations of P in M. But hence, there exist some formulas, phi 1 through phi m in P, such that m satisfies conjunction overall k from 1 to m, conjunction overall I from 0 to n, phi k of vi implies that sum two of the v's are equal. So vi is equal to vj for sum I not equal to j. In particular, we have that the set of all C in M, such that M satisfies the conjunction over all J from 1 to M phi J of C, is an A definable set of size N containing B. So this set is A definable because each of the formulas phi j comes from P, and P was a type over the set of parameters capital A. And it has this set has only finitely many realizations, namely n realizations, because M satisfies this condition. So together this shows that B is algebraic over A, as wanted, and concludes the proof of the proposition.